Your friend Spock is a logical man. A very logical man.
You're part Vulcanian, aren't you? Ah, well then, a pretty face doesn't affect you at all, does it? That is, not unless you want it to. You can save it, girls. This type can turn himself off from any emotion.
Labeled, do not make arguments.
All right. There's something wrong about a man who never smiles, whose conversation never varies from the routine of the job, and who won't talk about his background.
I see.
Spock. I mean that it's odd for a non-Vulcan. The ears make all of the difference.
I find your arguments strewn with gaping defects in logic.
Most Maybe. Illogical reaction. When we demonstrated our superior weapons, they should have fled.
You mean they should have respected us?
Of course.
Mr. Spock, respect is a rational process. Did it ever occur to you they might react emotionally? With anger?
Doctor, I'm not responsible for their unpredictability.
They were perfectly predictable. To anyone with feeling, you might as...
But not this minute, Spock. It takes us a little longer.
I understand the feeling, Captain.
You talk about another man's feelings. What do you feel, Spock?
My feelings are not a subject for discussion, Doctor.
Because there are no feelings to discuss.
Mr. Spock, Chekhov is dead. I see it now, and I can hardly believe it. But you work closely with him. That deserves some memorial.
Spock will have no truck with grief, Scotty. It's human.
Bones, Scotty.
Captain, it's quite all right. They forget I am half human.
You are the different one, Mr. Spock. You do not think like the others. There are no colors to your patterns of logic. There's only black and white. You see all this around you, and yet you do not believe.
Came so interested in observing Gary, Mr. Mitchell.
Our subject is not Gary Mitchell. Our concern is, rather, what he is mutating into.
I know those from your planet aren't supposed to have feelings like we do, Mr. Spock. But to talk that way about a man you've worked next to for years is worse than...
We found a whole world of minds that worked just like yours. Logical, unemotional, completely pragmatic. And we poor, irrational humans whipped them in a fair fight. Now you'll find yourself back among us illogical humans again.
Which I find eminently satisfactory, Doctor. For nowhere am I so desperately needed as among a shipload of illogical...
You have one other choice. Kill Mitchell while you still can.
Get out of here.
It is your only other choice. Assuming you make it while you still have time.
Will you try for one moment to feel? At least act like you've got a heart.
You're right and a trained psychiatrist wrong.
Because she feels, I don't. All I know is logic. In my opinion, we'll be lucky if we can repair this ship and get away in time.
I prefer the concrete. The graspable, the provable.
You'd make a splendid computer, Mr. Spock.
That is very
kind
of you,
Captain. What do you expect from a simpering, devil-eared freak whose father was a computer and his mother an encyclopedia?
My mother was a teacher. My father, an ambassador.
Your father was a computer, like his son.
Spock, when they wake up, take them to security hold.
Captain, your analysis of the situation was flawless, anticipating that she would deny you admittance. However, the logic by which you arrived at your conclusion escapes me.
Mr. Spock, the women on your planet are logical. That's the only planet in this galaxy that can make that...
Guard did a very professional job on my back. I'd appreciate it if you'd hurry.
Yes, of course, Captain. You realize that the aim will, of course, be very crude.
I... don't care if you hit the broadside of a barn. Just hurry, please.
Captain, why should I aim at such a structure?
A mind spot.
Opportunity? Now, listen, Spock, you may be a wonderful science officer, but believe me, you couldn't sell fake patents to your mother.
I fail to understand why I should care to induce my mother to purchase falsified patents.
Curious. Most illogical. And I'm sick and tired of your logic.
We could use a little inspiration.
Strange. Step by step, I have made the correct and logical decisions.
And yet two men have died.
And you've brought our furry friends down on us.
Yes, I do seem to have miscalculated regarding them. And inculcated resentment on your parts. The sum of the parts cannot be greater than the whole.
But a little less analysis and more action. That's what we need, Mr. Spock.
Will we survive? Will you try to understand how we feel about our life here? About each other?
Emotions are alien to me. I'm a scientist.
Someone...
You're gonna leave here without them? Run off on some wild goose chase halfway across the galaxy just because you found a discrepancy in a hydrogen cloud?
Doctor, I'm chasing the captain, Lieutenant Uhura, and Ensign Chekov, not some wild aquatic fowl.
Mr. Spock, you have a remarkably logical and analytical mind.
Thank you.